Yo guys, I'm Leo from Leonerd, welcome back. And today, I'll be explaining you the exposure triangle or exposure tripod as I prefer to call it. You might be asking yourself, why triangle or why tripod? So, I like to call it tripod because it's easier to explain. So there are three main pillars to exposure, to a great exposed photo or video, which are aperture, that we'll be talking today, ISO, and shutter speed. So those three things sustain your photo or your video. Today we're talking about aperture. You might have heard what it is, but I know the struggle going through YouTube trying to learn it by yourself, because I was there too. I did it too. I learned aperture, ISO, and all the things I'm talking about in this video by myself. So I'll try to explain the simplest way possible so you can get a nice understanding of what I'm talking about. Every camera lens has a thing called iris. The iris closes and opens, but it never gets fully closed. When it's open, you have more light going in and a brighter image. When it's closed, you have less light coming in and a darker image. For you to maneuver your aperture, you have to know a numerical relation, but it's not complicated, and get yourself used because we are going to use that on ISO and shutter as well. But it's nothing difficult, it doesn't involve calculations, just numbers. The camera will do the rest for you. So these numbers for aperture are called f-stops. So you have different f-stops from darker to brighter. Let's say I have in this hand a lens at f1.4 and in this hand a lens at f22. The lens at 1.4 will have more light getting in the sensor, because the iris will be more open than the other one. So it's basically exchanged. The lower the number, the higher the amount of light that goes in. And the higher the number, the lower the amount of light. So if you have a small number, that means it will be brighter. If you have a bigger number, a higher number, it will be darker. Always keep in mind that different lenses have different minimum apertures. By minimum, I mean brightest. So this one, is the minimum is 3.5, and this one, the minimum is 4. So that means when the iris on both is fully open, this one will capture more light. And that is what makes lenses more expensive. So keep that in mind when you're buying your lenses. Keep in mind that aperture does not only matter for the light that is going in your sensor, but as well as the blur. You probably have seen a photo with that blurry background that only the subject is in focus and everything, the rest is completely blown away, the background. Only your foreground is like sharp. So that is what lenses do, what apertures do. So this one is f4, this one is 1.8. Again, 1.8 will have more blur than f4, and that will continue. f22 is like the sharpest you can get for a aperture. So if you are shooting 1.8 and you want to focus in like 2 persons, it probably won't work. I'm not guaranteeing, because there are many factors that can interfere, but it probably won't work. It will only focus on your one person and the other one will be completely blurry. So you have to keep that in mind. If you want a blurry background in your photo, you put your aperture in the lower numbers. If you want everything in focus, everything sharp and looking nice, crisp, you have to put higher numbers, like f8 to f16, that's all good, because f22 will be too dark. So you gotta balance that with the other things that I will teach you, which is ISO and the shutter. And well, once you get all that balance, your photos will start looking amazing and you will control how you want them to look. Because like, if you use auto mode in your camera, that's okay if you are shooting like your kids running, because you don't need that style, that control of light, the auto will do just fine. But let's say you want to do it in your style, you want things darker or brighter, you have to know how to use that. You have to know how to get those things together, those three pillars together, to compose a nice image, a image that is your character. So guys, this video will end here. I hope you liked. I tried to explain everything in the simplest way possible. It's not as hard as it looks, but if you don't grab your camera and try every button, try different settings, ISOs, apertures, shutters, you won't be able to get better results. The only thing that separates me from a completely beginner is that I've tried everything, different combinations, and I saw what worked. And as soon as it works, you just get that pattern and repeat it, because it's working. And you guys gotta do that too. You gotta see what works for you. You gotta find your style, your photography, your videography style. And sometimes those are related to this small things like the aperture. Oh, that guy, that famous guy only films things with the shallow depth of field, which is the blurry background. He knows how to use his aperture. So you gotta do that. You gotta search everything, every resource you have on your camera, and try. So if you like the video, please leave it a like, subscribe if you haven't already, and turn on post notifications, the little bell icon, so you know when I post another videos like the ones of ISO and shutter that are coming up. I'll see you soon, and bye bye.